So my name is Ryan Landis. I'm here at the University of Massachusetts of Amherst, working under Professor Vincent Rotello. My research typically entails developing polymer-based materials, nanomaterials specifically, used for therapeutic delivery of proteins and antimicrobial applications. I was born in York, Pennsylvania, shortly after moved to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. So when I was a young kid, my mother actually gave me a book on rocks and minerals. Kids growing up, they wanted to be firefighters or policemen or astronauts. You know, I wanted to be a geologist. For some reason, I thought looking at rocks was pretty interesting. One of the materials that interested me was quartz. And it turned out I grew up on a mountain, so we had a plethora of quartz. So I would just spend my days just, you know, collecting every single quartz. My dad wasn't too happy about it, though, because it would always the rocks would get lodged in his lawnmower. But my parents always supported my interest in, you know, anything science related. Going into high school, I got away from geology because geology seemed a little bit too static for me. I was more interested in dynamic systems, things that change over time. So the first one that I became interested in afterwards was chemistry. Something about chemistry and understanding how molecules form, how they interact, and how they can assemble really interests me tremendously. So it was kind of like being a construction worker on the nano level, which I kind of thought was interesting. I always was interested growing up, you know, building and constructing things. And I think if you had a tool set to be able to construct the thing on the nano level, that's kind of interesting. So that's really what drew me to it. An easy way to think of what a polymer actually is that if you actually take a single entity, a single type of structure, and have it repeating over many, many units, that is typically what we classify as a polymer. So the ultimate goal is to be able to design polymeric systems that can be used for delivery or antimicrobial systems. These have inherent challenges in and itself. In order to have good adhesion onto wherever, such as bacteria, biofilms, or, you know, tumor cells, cationic or positively charged materials are preferential. However, it's noticed that cationic-based polymers can be kind of toxic. So developing a system which can do what it actually needs to do without having inherent toxicity is an issue. So the overall goal is to be able to deliver your payload to do its job without any having any, you know, negative side effects to normal healthy cells. Dynamic systems interest me tremendously. So one of the reasons why I joined the group that I'm in, Professor Rotello's group, is that it's very dynamic, very diverse. And I like that because I enjoy actually learning new things. You know, I try and learn little bits and pieces, whether it's actual the language itself or culture or certain customs.
And you can always have different outcomes.
In this group, we have Chinese, Taiwanese, Vietnamese. We've had visiting scholars from Turkey, Germany, France, you know, all over the place. And I like that because it just keeps things interesting. You know, it always keeps open for new opportunities and new things to learn every day. In order to be successful in research and in science, you have to be willing to do whatever it takes. You have to be driven to be successful, to be motivated. And sometimes that motivation has to come from yourself. You know, you got to ask yourself, why do you get up every single day? Do you get up just to get through the next day and the next day? Or do you get up because you want to make a difference? It comes down to one fundamental question that I always ask myself is, how bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? Are you willing to do whatever it takes to progress science? You know, because you have to be willing to get out of your comfort zone too. There's times where things don't work. In fact, I'll be honest with you, there's times when most things do not work. But it's how well can you deal with that? We'll be right back.